Hello there, my fellow blue-skinned high-tech aliens, and welcome back to a series which I kinda left in limbo for a while. This is our overall lore series on the Tau Empire. Now, in the past, we already talked about multiple vehicles of theirs, including the Devilfish, the Hammerhead, the Piranha, and the Skyray. Now that I actually listed all that, it does seem that the Tau do like to name everything after fish. And that practice is not gonna change today either, as we shall talk about the Sun Shark Bomber. Do stay until the end and vote on a future topic as well. I'm your host, the Grimdark Narrator, and without further ado, let us proceed, shall we? The Sun Shark Bomber is a Tau aircraft designed to provide support to Tau ground forces. It was first designed and deployed sometime during the Second Sphere expansion, with the Sun Shark proving its success rapidly against the many foes of the Tau Empire. For example, during the invasion of the Highfleet Gorgon on the Tau Sept world of Kel'Shan, the aliens quickly grew afraid of the dominating Tau air attacks. Or at least they would have if the Tyranids actually felt fear. High up in the stratosphere, the super-heavy Manta bombers blasted away the alien horrors, while just above the planet's surface swept the Sun Shark bombers, their pulse bombs breaking up swarming Hormagaunt armies with mighty blasts. They were instrumental in holding back the Tyranid swarms, and without them, the Tau battle line would have been overrun. A Sun Shark bomber consists of a central chassis with two large forward-mounted wings, which are connected to additional small winglets in the rear of the main body by thruster rods. The cockpit is fully enclosed and pressurized, and its sleek design includes two interceptor drones, which fit into specially designed recesses in the aircraft's wings. The main weapon of a Sun Shark is the pulse bomb generator, which is mounted underneath the rear portion of the airframe. Mounted on the front of the central body is a nose-mounted networked marker light. It is powered by a complex dual anti-gravitic and jet propulsion motive system, so that the aircraft can swiftly fly above a planet's surface. Its armored bulk is primarily driven forwards by two powerful jet engines mounted on the sides of the main airframe. Additional thruster rods connected to the wings allow the aircraft to turn better than it would otherwise be able to, while the large wings granted better stability in the air. The natural skills of the pilots allow the aircraft to maneuver with a skill, precision, and extremity which only members of the air caste can tolerate. Like pretty much all Tau vehicles, the armor of this wing is made of the dense nanocrystalline metal called Fiotak, which is light, strong, corrosive-resistant, and malleable, and also reduces the weight of the vehicle while also providing excellent protection. All the Sun Sharks are piloted by a member of the air caste, as evident by the air caste symbols displayed on the wings. The pilot both controls the aircraft and operates the weapons, with the assistance of some drone-controlled systems. It is often that the attack shoals of the air caste that are first loosed upon an enemy world, swooping down in great waves to clear the skies, are the flyers. Anti-aircraft defenses are blasted out of existence from low orbit, or else marked for punitive strikes by teams of stealth or crisis battlesuits. The plasma bombs fall like rain upon the enemy airfields, ripping apart landing pads and runways, and blasting Promethium silos and grounded fighters into slag. Those enemy aircraft that do make it into the sky find themselves running the gauntlet among swarms of perfectly coordinated Tau attack craft. The Tau pilots maintain meticulously calculated formations and lay down lattices of interceptor fire. These will see even the biggest and most heavily armed and armored enemy aircraft spinning groundwards like flaming comets. By the time the ground war begins properly, enemy air assets have been reduced to a shadow of their former power, and the skies belong to the Tau. It is at this point that the shoals of Sun Shark bombers will switch to targeting the enemy ground forces. They are employed in place of artillery, supporting their firecast comrades, by executing deadly attack runs, shattering enemy infantry and fire support formations. Due to their unique fighting tendency and their highly mobile nature, the Hunter cadres do not use artillery in the conventional sense that most armies do. Instead, in association with the Aircast, they have developed the Sunshark Bomber. Shoals of these aircraft fly in tight formation and can blast apart even a horde of an Orc Wa with a single flyover, for their pulse bombs are devastating against hordes of infantry. The Tau Doctrine places great importance upon dominating the airways above any battlefield they will deploy to. It is their commonly held belief that controlling the skies is the first step in winning the engagement, and the Tau aircraft like the Razor Shark and the Barracuda enable them to do this. By making the elimination of enemy flyers a priority, the ground troops are then allowed to concentrate on their targets without having to concern themselves with any threat from above. This strategy thereby enables the Tau to make full use of their ground assets as well. With no other enemy flyers to worry about, the Sun Sharks are better able to line their devastating bombing runs, while Razor Sharks fly circles around enemy infantry and armor, using the range and potent hitting power of their ion weapons to pick off their enemies beyond the range of return fire. With full aerial supremacy, the Tau are free to concentrate their flexible firepower when and how they want to, efficiently isolating and destroying enemy assets one at a time. In the hands of an experienced Tau commander, the fine-tuned coordination of air attacks in the skies above the battlefield can make a Hunter cadre very adaptable and very lethal. During an attack run, the Sun Sharks are a blur of motion, and the crews are far more likely to trust their speed and their jinking ability over any amount of armor. Using this extreme speed, the Sun Shark can rapidly pass over an enemy before they even realize they are there. There were many desperate Pathfinder or Fire Warrior teams that owe their existence to the Sun Shark shoals, most notably due to the Seeker missiles they carry, which they call in using a marker light. Their ability to make short work of armored infantry or enemy vehicles, with the help of nearby air support, greatly increases their chance of survival. It is also worth noting that the Sun Sharks are able to operate very well in space, often fulfilling the role of attack raft for the Tau fleets in void combat by performing void-based bombing missions on enemy capital starships. As mentioned already, the main armament of the Sun Shark is the rear pulse bomb generator mounted underneath the hull. This device produces a ball of deadly plasma beneath the aircraft. At the pilot's command, a pulsed induction field propels the energy ball towards the battlefield below. Sizzling the air around it, a pulse bomb explodes on the ground with incandescent fury, spreading destruction over a wide radius and leaving little but drifting ash and glowing craters to show where the enemy once stood. A very efficient weapon, the pulse bomb generator can continue manufacturing fresh ordnance for the craft almost indefinitely without the need for rearming. You definitely know that the Tau are cheating when they have literally infinite ammo. Sometimes, however, so as to not be completely OP, a persistent glitch from the weapon's prototype days results in a power failure, meaning that the Sun Shark cannot make any more bombs until the engineers can fix it. At other times, the microfactory can slip out of alignment during battle, requiring reconfiguration before bomb production can continue. Outside of this pulse bomb generator, a Sun Shark is equipped with a nose-mounted, networked marker light to line up the bombing runs. It also bears a tail-mounted missile pod as part of the armament, which can be upgraded to a twin-linked version. This gives the bomber a self-defense weapon against enemy aircraft, although it can also be used effectively against light-armored vehicles on the ground. To further ensure that the Sun Shark survives long enough to deliver its payload, the vehicle is mounted with a pair of wing-mounted interceptor drones. Each one is armed with powerful twin-linked ion rifles, and they can either stay attached to the Sun Shark, where they act in a similar way to a turret, or they can detach from the flyer and serve as an escort. When disembarking from the Sun Shark, the drones will often position themselves to intervene between the bomber and any oncoming enemy fighter. They also have the ability to boost their jets, giving them a rare burst of speed which allows them to better position themselves and lock onto aerial targets and attempt to blast them out of the sky. Very few enemy flyers are capable of withstanding the vaporizing effects of an ion rifle, and some interceptor drones have racked up a more impressive kill count than the aircraft they belong to. For even more support, it has two Seeker missiles. These missiles can be auto-fired by the Sunshark's aircast pilot, but are more effective when launched by a ground unit that has painted the target with a marker light. The Seeker missiles on the Sunsharks are especially deadly, as the aircraft's ability to rapidly position itself on the flanks of the battlefield allows the missiles to strike at more vulnerable side or rear armor of enemy vehicles. Other upgrades that the Sunshark can mount include an automated repair system, an advanced targeting system, black sun filter, decoy launchers, a disruption pod, point defense targeting relay, and sensor spines. And so we arrive at today's poll, which will be about more Tau units. But this time, I'm gonna keep it a bit more general. Would you like to see more, option A, Tau aircraft or spaceships? Or option B, more Tau battlesuits? To vote, just write down your choice in the comments below. Thank you for participating. And all of that, my friends, has been what I wanted to tell you about the powerful and versatile Sunshark Bomber. It also has a successor of a kind called the Razor Shark, which I might cover if you guys vote for it. Were you familiar with this Tau aircraft prior to this video? Is it among your favorite Tau units? What do you like or dislike most about it? You can let us know all that and any other stories or facts about it you may know in the comments below. If you found the episode informative or entertaining, please click the like, share, and subscribe buttons for future content. You can also click the bell notification icon to stay more up to date. Thank you very much for watching to the end, and I wish you all a great and healthy day. For the greater good!